Welcome to my continuation of my series of watching and reviewing all the Dorothy movies that I have on DVD. So currently I say Dorothy movie marathon. And after I watch and review all the Dorothy movies that I have on DVD for y'all, then next month I'll pick another actor or actress that have a bunch of their movies on DVD, and then I'll watch and review all their movies that I have on DVD, and I'll keep doing it for another 3 or 4 months. And this is something new that I'm doing. Each month I pick a different actor and I watch all the movies that I have on DVD. Okay. I never done it before. I might done it 1 or 2 times, like in the past. Watch like all John Wayne movies or Clint Eastwood movies. You know, binge watch, do a marathon and watching all Clint Eastwood movies or John Wayne movies in the past. Okay, but whenever I want to watch a movie, I don't watch random movie or it's the upcoming Game Bond movie. I go back and watch all the Game Bond movies, leading up to the Game Bond movie, or it's the upcoming Marvel movie. I go back and watch all the Marvel movie, or it's the upcoming Star Wars movie. Go back and watch all. Go back and watch all the Star Wars movies. Okay, mainly that how I watch movies. Either do that or watch a movie that I'm in the mood for. Okay, so this is something that I'm gonna try to do for the next 3 or 4 months. Okay, so most of the actors and actresses that I'm watching, all the movies that I have on DVD for that 3 or 4 months, I would consider them like my favorite actors and actress. If I came up with my like top 10 or top 20 or top 30 list. Okay. So for this Dorothy movie review, I'm going to review Love Me or Leave Me. Is it gonna be my Love Me or Leave Me movie review? Okay. So when I was growing up, all I wanted to watch was 3 things: Game Bond, John Wayne, and Dorothy. Okay, so Rotten Tomatoes gave it a 71%. The audience gave it a 75%. Okay. This movie is directed by Sean Bendor, starring Dorothy, James Cagney, Cameron Mitchell, release date May 26, 1955, running time 122 minutes, cost $2.76 million, and made $5.6 million at the box office, okay? And it said it's a fictionalized account of the career of jazz singer Ruth Etting and her temporary marriage to gangster Marty Schneider, who helped propel her to stardom. Okay. Rooster Ethan, that's what Dorothy play. Look up Ruth Etting, E-T-T-I-N-G, Ruth Etting. Her mother died when She was 5 years old, and she then lived with her paternal grandparents, George and Hannah Ethan. Her father remarried and moved away from David City and was no longer a part of his daughter's life. Okay, so that's a brief thing I got on Wikipedia. So they don't show that in the movie. So they changed stuff around the movie. Okay. I didn't know that this was a real person in real life. This is the first time I ever seen this movie. Like I said a while ago, I did grow up with Dorte. I was a big fan of Dorte growing up. The movie that I grew up with Dorte was The Thrill of It All, The Man Who Knew Too Much, Pillow Talk, and Clammy Jack. Okay? Doe was the Dorte movie that made me became a Dorte fan. And there were a couple other ones that I think like one or two times when I was little, but I didn't watch them that much. Like, Don't Eat the Daisy or Teacher Pet. I think like one or two times when I was little, or Bits and Pieces, or stuff like that, okay? Okay, but in this movie, I think the best performance in this movie is Dan Cadney. I like how he's crazy in this movie. He's yelling at people, slapping people. Toward the end of the movie, he shoots the other guy that kind of like Dorothy's in love with, the piano player. He's like a crazy guy, okay? I know how in some movies Dorothy have long hair, in some movies she have short hair, and I don't get it, okay? And I don't know if in some movies she wears a wig, or some movies she don't. So I don't know, okay? But I like her with longer hair, okay? It seemed to me that most of her movies, a lot of her movies, it's the same plot. She wants to fame, Beyonce and stuff like that. But Dan Cadney was a standout performance in this movie. Not Dorte at the time, but I thought Dorte was okay, but James Cadney was crazy in this movie, you know, slapping Dorte, yelling at people, doing that to the, clanging the drinks around at the bar, so punching people, so this is a movie that I need to watch again. But it seemed like in a lot of Dorothy Day movies, they ain't funny. They seem like when they end, they the end, and they don't tie up the movie, you know, summer up the movie. The movie to feel rushed at the end, oh, the end, something like that. I'm gonna give Love Me or Leave Me a C plus. So this is a movie that, at And I was watching it, I'm like, nah, I don't like it. And then after Andy got going, Game Cadney, his character, were really going crazy, and I got into it really good, really vetted. So this is a movie that I probably need to watch again, and see how I either like it more or like it less over here. And you know, the first 20 minutes of the movie, I didn't really like it, and then after that, I got into it. So that's my review, and use my channel, hit the like button, because I think of